Hola, El Paso, ¿qué tal? Thank you for joining us on another edition of Your City in 5. I'm your host, Ricky Saillas. I'm with Mario Ramirez, media specialist for the city of El Paso. We're enjoying a cup of joe here at a local coffee shop. It's all part of the Coffee with a Cop initiative that's happening this month. We're going to tell you more about that program in a moment, but first, it's hard to believe, but we're already halfway through the month of December. A lot happening in the city of El Paso. Here's a look at what's happening across the city. The number of COVID-19 cases continues to climb across El Paso. The message from the Public Health Department to protect against the virus remains the same. Get vaccinated or get a booster, use a face covering indoors, and wash your hands. As cases rise, the Office of Emergency Management, in partnership with the state, has opened a new regional infusion center to provide an outpatient treatment that helps high-risk people with the virus stay out of the hospital. It's located on 9341 Alameda in the Mission Valley. It's in addition to the Hospitals of Providence Infusion Center, and it's open every day of the week, but patients do need a referral from a doctor to receive this type of therapy. The state has also created mobile infusion teams for people who can't make it out to the center.
The community to receive this infusion and to make it more available. We already had one center that was providing this infusion, but we needed to expand the services to many others that are becoming infected, and that is the reason why the city is making this infusion also available.
The city has also expanded COVID-19 vaccine and testing services. The Office of Emergency Management has reopened the nation's Tobin drive-through testing site, and they have expanded the hours of the mega testing sites. Nation's Tobin, along with the county sports park and the UTEP testing site, will be open from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday through Sunday. The testing site on High Ridge will be open from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday through Saturday. Also, the Isleta Clinic on Candelaria Street is providing free COVID-19 vaccines and COVID testing by appointment. And as a bonus, you can get free flu shots without an appointment. More information on all of this is available at epstrong.org. Medical studies have shown that regular exercise can reduce the risk of COVID-19 related hospitalizations and make our immune system stronger to help fight the virus. But with the pandemic and the holidays, it can be tricky to stay active. Live Active El Paso can help. This month, the Wellness Initiative is providing free exercise sessions and activities for people of all ages at several city facilities. This includes mental health and nutrition classes. If you can't make it out to the classes, Live Active EP encourages everyone to stay active by walking, running, riding a bicycle, or any sort of physical activity that can improve mental health, emotional, and physical health. Get more information on these classes and events by visiting the calendar of events on liveactiveep.com. Cheers, officers. Cheers. Thank you. Well, the El Paso Police Department has rolled out a new initiative called Coffee with a Cop. It's an opportunity for El Pasoans to meet with El Paso police officers at a local coffee shop and ask them just about anything that's on their mind. The department restarted its Coffee with a Cop program this month. Residents can meet the men and women in blue and have a conversation with them on just about anything.
Coffee with the Cop is something that we try to do so we can come out to the community and interact with the community. At the same time, have a casual conversation over coffee.
To see when Coffee with a Cop is in your neighborhood, visit the El Paso Police Department Facebook page. Good news for El Pasoans who use the Women, Infants, and Children's program to buy groceries. A temporary increase in the dollar amount available to purchase fruits and vegetables has been extended through March of next year. WIC provides supplemental food benefits for thousands of El Pasoans. To learn more or to see if you qualify for the food benefit, call the number on the bottom of your screen. You can help bring some hope to shelter pets this holiday season by choosing to adopt your next pet. The El Paso Animal Services and the Bissell Pet Foundation are teaming up once again to offer free pet adoptions on all shelter pets now through December 20th.
Our goal is to get as many pets out of the shelter and into great homes. The shelter right now, for being the month of December, is definitely filled with lots of great pets right now. And more pets continue to come in that may be needing help as well, whether they're too young to be adopted at the time. So if you're not looking to adopt, you also can foster.
If you're looking to add a new member to your family, you can visit the Animal Services Center on Fred Wilson 7 days a week. And so far this year, 2,500 pets from the shelter have been flown from El Paso to rescue groups across the nation and Canada through the El Paso Animal Services Transport Program. More shelter pets are going to have a chance to take flight thanks to a generous grant from PetSmart Charities. Animal Services received a $75,000 grant from the organization that is going towards rescue and transport efforts. To find out ways how you can help rescue efforts at the shelter, visit ElPasoAnimalServices.org. There are a few more weeks left of WinterFest, and if you haven't made it out yet, you're missing out. There's plenty of holiday cheer with live performances at San Jacinto Plaza every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. The lights at the plaza also make for great pictures. They turn on at 5 p.m. every day. Looks like you're in the holiday spirit, amigo.
Well, yeah, I mean, as a local musician, I hear the Streetcar's got live performances.
You know what? You're absolutely right. The Streetcar does have live performances, and it's all part of WinterFest. Not only can you take the Streetcar to check out downtown and part of the uptown area, but you can also see local performers. Now, we caught up with one band. Check this out.
Oh, it's great. It's a good opportunity for the kids to show up, to showcase their talent. I think this is the best way to get people to see, you know, that we have good talent in El Paso.
I am here supporting School of Rock. My daughter is a drummer.
I think I started playing the drums when I was around 10 years old. I think this is awesome. Like, I love this. I didn't think it was going to be like that. I thought it was going to be much smaller. But like, this is awesome.
One, two,
ready, go.
I think it's awesome. I think they should keep doing it, and I think it's a good opportunity for everyone, right, to showcase their talent and then have the public be able to support it.
Dude, those kids could play, man.
Right? Some talented kids from the School of Rock that just played not too long ago.
How often do they have music on the Streetcar?
So you know what? They have music on the Streetcar every weekend. Now, it's free, but you do need to wear a mask to get on the Streetcar. Now, if you want to find a list of performers, you can visit the Streetcar on Instagram and Facebook. And also, if you want to check out where the Streetcar runs, just go ahead and download the app. The city of El Paso is featured on the cover of the December issue of Tar Arolinas in-flight publication Star News. The cover story includes a four-page spread that talks about all there is to do in the Sun City, from shopping to outdoor adventures and the recent economic and quality of life investments made in downtown El Paso. You can find the magazine on all 18 destination flights provided by the Mexican-based airline. And that's going to do it for us on this edition of Your City in 5. From Mario Ramirez, who's behind the camera, and all of the officers at the El Paso Police Department, we'll see you next time
on Your City in 5.